So when you think of, the terminology is either posterior blepharitis, or the terminology I like to use is meibomian gland dysfunction. This is, of course, critical. There's a recent study that showed that 86% of all dry eye is caused by evaporative causes, specifically meibomian gland dysfunction. And so from a treatment regimen, you have to keep in mind that there's typically at least 3 to 4, well, probably 4 key components to the management of MGD. If you look at what's happening at the effect level, you have obstruction of the glands, whether they're inspissated, they're plugged, they're turbid in expression, paste-like, or even non-producing. Besides obstruction, you have a tear film abnormality, you have inflammation, and then finally you have a formation of biofilms. That's why you often see anterior blepharitis with a MGD component. So the key is to address all four. If you just address one, the patient's never going to get a lot better, and you might treat symptoms, but the disease progresses. So you have to really affect all four of those. So for obstruction, you could use a warm compress, preferably some sort of a commercial type brand. You could teach patients how to do that effectively. You could use thermal pulsation. There's a lot of options, but you have to do that, even if it's just debriding the lower eyelid. Secondly, probably one of the most important things is lid hygiene, because the biofilms lead to severe damage. They can cause the surface of glands to have keratin deposition and lead to less production. Eventually, those glands do atrophy. So you have to take care of that. And that's a good lid hygiene product. I'd recommend OcuSoft Lid Scrub Plus. That seems to be my preference. It's a leave-on solution. And if you had a significant amount of inflammation of that margin, which would be indicated by hyperemia, ptyalosis, or thickening of the glands, severe telangiectasia, that sort of thing, then I would actually recommend the OcuSoft Lid Scrub Plus Platinum, because the phytosphingosine actually really works well to decrease inflammation in those patients. The third is inflammation, and that could be addressed by any range. If you have a severe case, it might be oral doxycycline formations. It might be omega fatty acids. It might be azithromycin in the oral form. But it could also be topical steroids, combination agents, and even cyclosporine. But you have to address the inflammation as a secondary for sure. And then the last thing is the tear film abnormality. If you have MGD or meibomian gland dysfunction, your lipid layer is typically not thick enough. It's usually deficient and not of good quality. So until that's working again by treating the other three components, you're going to have to include artificial tears that replace it. My preference for the treatment of MGD is Retain MGD. I've seen wonderful results with that product in patients. It's preservative-free, and you can cap the top, but what that allows is patients to do very well with getting a non-preservative buildup, and it has a certain emulsion combination that just seems to work so effectively. I've had rarely a patient that's used that for MGD without expressing how wonderful that's been in treating their symptoms. So I think you have to address all four components, and when you do, patients typically do extremely well. Keep in mind, these are chronic conditions, so for long term, they're going to have some sort of maintenance, which is often including some component of those four options.